chili in the name of...
Again, and welcome to season 2, episode 10 of Chilli in the Name of, special Australia Day edition. Today I will be road testing 3 sorts from one of Australia's legendary makers, Mr. Taco Rodriguez from the Chile Banditos, including the Cream of the Carribean Pirates Reserve range citrus and chili dressing, the Descent into Lucifer's Garden Pirates Reserve range berry bourbon hot sauce, and the Battle of Captain Braveheart extra hot hot sauce. Now, the founder and proprietor of the Chile Banditos is one Taco Rodriguez, also known as Aaron Hargraves. I pretty much blame Taco Rodriguez for my obsession with chilies ever since he invited me to join the Chile Banditos on Facebook. But he's got a bit of a legendary standing here in Australia as kind of a big advocate for chili sauces and for Texan-style barbecue. So without any further ado, let's get on it. So the first sauce I'm going to try today is called the Cream of the Carribean Pirates Reserve Range Citrus and Chili Dressing. It's got this nice yellowish colour. You can see there's chunks of bits and pieces in there, a bit of colour in there, sort of red. There might be even some coriander leaves in there. Let's try it. Yeah, first off, the smell. It smells a bit like a salad dressing. See how it pours. That's really good. It's a vinaigrette style dressing. You can really taste the lemon and lime right there. The chili's sort of kicking in afterwards. I can taste there's mustard seeds in there and pepper. It's a really refreshing change from having chili sauces all the time that are just super hot. This is just really fresh and would go great on any salad. I'm really liking the way that the lime and the lemon are sitting right there in the front with in front of the vinegar, but yeah, no, that's really good. I mean, in terms of heat, it's probably 1 out of 10, but it's a really delicious flavor, and you could just go through this in one meal, I reckon, because it's that good. The second sauce I'm going to try today is the Descent into Lucifer's Garden Pirates Reserve Range Berry Bourbon Hot Sauce, and as you can see, it's on the front of it, it's got Satan's face or Lucifer's face covered in berries, with a couple of leaves and stuff there as well. It's a berry bourbon hot sauce, so it's got that berry color. It's very purple, kind of loose consistency. Let's try it out. All right, so you can smell the berries in that. That's really berry smoke. Bit of chili in there as well. Yeah, it's really all about the berries in that. Sits right at the front of the mouth with the berries and the sweetness of it, but it's sort of got a bit of smoke in there as well, and it's a heap hotter than the dressing, but it's not too hot. I think it's about maybe a 4 out of 10 for heat. It's a lot looser consistency than the first one too. Let's see what it has in it. Blackberry, blueberry, raspberry, habaneros. That's where the heat's coming from. Vinegar, bourbon, sugar, onion, spices, and pepper. That's really good. I'm sort of trying to work out what I would have that on. I mean, you could almost have that on ice cream, but at the same time, the smokiness kind of lends it towards more something a bit more savory as well. So yeah, Descent to Lucifer's Garden. Now this is a really special one here. This is the Battle of Captain Bravetongue, extra hot. He's given it a 10 out of 10 for heat level. It says that it's the main ingredient is super hot chilies, spices, vinegar, garlic, and xanthan gum to keep it the consistency and keep the particles floating in there. As you can see, there's a whole lot of seeds in there, and it's got a skull and crossbones pirate style on the front there. A skull and crossbones with a skull and crossbones on his hat, so it's double skull and crossbones, which is a little bit scary. Let's try it out. Oh, that smells amazing. Really smoky, really lots of chili up the front there. The spices smell really good. Looking forward to this. It says on the back, avoid contact with eyes and sensitive skin, and I can see that you would not want to rub this in your eyes, that's for sure. Look, it's a beautiful sort of rounded flavour. It's a more of sort of a barbecue-y sort of flavour. Barbecue sauce. It's a much more complex chili sauce than just straight up chili. With the spices and the garlic really sort of rounding it off beautifully. You can taste the super hots in there, and I'm assuming that's what all those seeds are in the bottom there, or inside the sauce there. Yeah, that's cracking. Definitely deserves the extra hot label. If you can get this, get it, if you really like your hot sauces. So that concludes Season 2, Episode 10 of Chilli in the Name Of. This is the last episode for Season 2. Happy Australia Day to those who are celebrating. Thanks again to Taco Rodriguez for sending me those Chilli Bandito sauces. They're all cracking. I reckon if you can get that, the Battle of Captain Braveheart, get on that. That's really special. As for me, I'll be back in Season 3 of Chilli in the Name Of, where I'll be trying out some new sauces from the USA, some local ones, and I'll also be joined again by Mr. Brian McNeil from Austin, Texas, who'll be trying out a couple with me at the same time. So I'm sure that's something to look forward to. Until then, see you later.
Chilli in the Name Of.